In the last half hour, we learned the man police say threatened a shooting on the U of M campus is in custody. Authorities say he was arrested without incident outside his home in Watson. It brings to a close a situation that started just after 7 this morning when the U sent out an alert about the shooting threat and asked people to stay away from campus. They gave the all clear just 2 hours ago once it was confirmed the suspect was in Watson. That's where Heidi Wigdahl is live right now. Heidi?
Hi, Lauren. We are just off of Highway 7, just a couple blocks away from downtown Watson. You can see the road is still closed behind me. Law enforcement has had the suspect's home surrounded all day. SWAT vehicles have been on both sides of that home. And about 40 minutes ago, we saw the suspect step outside his home. He backed up towards the SWAT vehicle with his hands in the air. Then law enforcement apprehended him. We arrived here around 2 this afternoon, and neighbors around here told me that this is what it looked like all day. They started closing down even more roads around 2:30, and shortly after that, we heard some loud pops coming from the area, which appeared to be a tactic to try to get him out of the home. The 41-year-old suspect has been posting about the situation on his landscaping business Facebook page. That's where that initial U of M threat came in. And we spoke with Jessica Stolen, the editor of the Montevideo American News. She did a couple interviews with him last winter, and she talked a lot about the charity projects he had been doing. He had spoke candidly about his mental health and addiction struggles, and she said it's just really sad for all the people who were rooting for him. At least 3 school districts in the area took extra precautions today, including 2 going on lockdown. And meanwhile, we heard from the U of M interim president, who sent a note to students and parents offering resources for people who need extra support. And he also said, quote, "While we can be assured the threat never reached our campus, there is no doubt events like this affect our sense of safety." Coming up tonight at 6, we're going to talk more. You're going to hear from Jessica more about the suspect. Back to you.
All right. Thank you, Heidi. And speaking of that suspect, Lou Ragus has been looking into his background and joins us now with what he found. Lou?
And Julie, we aren't naming the suspect because he has not been charged, but we wanted to report some details of his past to help give some insight into why authorities likely took this threat so seriously. The 41-year-old man from the small town of Watson has a history of bizarre drug and alcohol-fueled crimes that date back to 2016 when he was 34 years old. Court documents show just last month he was given a stayed 15-month sentence, meaning he wouldn't have to serve it unless he violated conditions, and he was placed on supervised probation. That after documents showed that he completely trashed a room at the Prairie's Edge Casino in June. Additional court documents show the suspect also had a felony conviction for crashing a tractor through the Watson Lutheran Church, then falling asleep on the altar. He was also arrested once after crashing his truck, telling police he was trying to get away from the people in his head. In 2016, he was civilly committed, diagnosed with having delusional disorder and severe stimulant use disorder. If he's charged in connection to the U of M threat, this man will likely also face probation violations from some of those past offenses. Prior to his mental health issues and criminal behavior, this man served as mayor of the small town of Watson for a 2-year term starting back in 2012.